Hello everyone, my name's Matt and welcome to another week of Vectra News. Here's what's coming up in today's episode. Activision announced a remastered prototype bundle for current gen consoles, Shenmue 3 sets a new Kickstarter record for the highest funded video game, and the Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection will be receiving a playable demo this summer. Another week goes by and another remastered game appears, this time with Activision announcing a bundle for PS4 and Xbox One that will include both Prototype 1 and 2 games and all DLC that was released for them. Now, while there are always those who like the idea of remastered titles and the others who hate them, this bundle in particular seems to be receiving much more hate than usual. In fact, the trailer that was uploaded on Activision's YouTube channel has users making mostly negative comments and criticisms. But why is this remastered edition causing up such a stir? Well, for a start, if you're expecting to play through Prototype 2 at a glorious 60 frames per second, you'll be disappointed to hear that it runs at 30 frames per second at best, with game parts even dropping to 25 to 25 frames per second, with screen tearing occurring on a regular basis. So based on performance tests and comparisons of the Xbox One version, Prototype actually runs better on the last gen consoles. What's even more depressing is that because of this bundle, we probably won't be able to play the original Xbox 360 versions of the games through backwards compatibility. You know, the ones that actually run better. These remastered editions seem to be popping up everywhere lately, as by the end of this year, there will be more than 20 games released that are either classed as remasters or definitive editions. In fact, this YouTube comment by user 01AnimeKing seems to sum up gaming for 2015 quite well, as he puts, "Next gen, where you go to play games from previous gen." Funnily enough though, we actually had a discussion about remastered games in the most recent episode of our podcast, The Spawn Point, so if this particular subject matter is something you feel strongly about, then it's definitely worth checking out and letting us know what you think. Onto some more positive news, Shenmue 3 has managed to set a new record on Kickstarter after raising a total of $6.3 million. This amount makes the game not only the 6th highest funded Kickstarter campaign, but also the number 1 highest funded video game on the site. The Kickstarter for Shenmue 3 was announced during Sony's E3 press conference last month, and it was later stated that Sony would not receive any of the funding received from Kickstarter. Because of this insane level of funding, half of the stretch goals were reached, which includes Shenmue 1 and 2 cinema shorts, German, French, Italian, and Spanish subtitles, a rapport system, a skill tree system, additional quests, missions, mini-games, and also a character perspective system. If you're one of those who is excited for this game, be sure to let us know in the comments. Staying on the topic of remastered games though, Uncharted The Nathan Drake Collection will be receiving a playable demo fairly soon. That's according to Sony, who have stated we can expect it to be released on the PlayStation Store later this summer. In addition to this news about this demo, screenshots and gameplay of Uncharted 2 have been revealed. In fact, the gameplay you're watching right now is what you can expect from the remastered PS4 version. Now, unlike the prototype bundle, all three Uncharted games will run at 60 frames per second and will feature a new photo mode and trophy support. The collection will also feature a new difficulty mode known as Brutal and the removal of the annoying motion controls that were present on the PS3 versions. Unfortunately though, none of these games in the collection will have multiplayer, apart from access to the Uncharted 4 multiplayer beta that is expected to start sometime in either December or January. If you're looking to pick up a copy of the Nathan Drake Collection, the game will be available on October 7th in North America and October 9th in Europe. But that's all for Vectra News this week. Don't forget to like and share this video if you have enjoyed it. Follow us on Twitter and Facebook to stay up to date with everything. And most importantly, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you'd like to see more content from us. Other than that, I have been Matt, and I'll see you guys later.